If you've never worked with data before, trying to understand it can be a little bit daunting. But once you get the hang of it, it's actually pretty easy. In this video series, we'll teach you some tricks to format your data, specifically focusing on using Excel. In general, there are three things we recommend when formatting your data. The three things are starting your data in cell A1, having the first row be your column headers, and have every subsequent row be one piece of data. In this video, let's talk about that first thing, starting your data in cell A1, and why you want to do this. When you connect your data to Tableau Public, Tableau reads the very first row to determine what are the different data fields that you have within your data set. If you either have blank space or really large titles at the very top, kind of like this, your data might not get entered into Tableau properly. In fact, let's actually take a look at what this data looks like once you connect it to Tableau if you leave it in this particular format. You can see it's very difficult to make heads or tails of your data set when it simply has field names that look like this, F and a certain number. We can actually also see the title of our data set here, even though it's not actually a piece of data in and of itself. So when you have your data set, the best thing to do is actually get rid of all of these different pieces of information that you don't need. This also means you should get rid of all other extraneous bits of information, such as headers that explain entire series of columns grouped like this. Let's go ahead and delete that. The other thing you should be careful of are totals, such as things that you might find down here at the bottom that sum up all of the different values for either a given set of columns or a given set of rows. While they're useful when looking at the Excel file itself, the totals themselves are not actual data points. Tableau, on its own, can actually very easily aggregate all of the data points into sums, totals, averages, what have you. So we don't need to have them within the data set. Ideally, this data set that we have right now should look like this. I've gotten rid of the title, the descriptions. My data starts right away in cell A1. There are no group titles for all the different columns, and there are no totals. The only thing I have in this data set is just my data. And when we put it into Tableau Public, you see that we can now very easily tell what all the different data fields we have within our data set are, and now it's very easy to just go ahead and create visualizations based on it. In our next video, we'll talk about what actually makes up a certain column in a data set, and why sometimes you want certain columns to actually be grouped together. If you have any questions, leave us a comment in the description below, or email us at social@tableausoftware.com.